We start in the south of Spain, traveling from Malaga into the backcountry to Antequera, a medieval town famous for the walls and towers of its Moorish fortress. And this is the venue for the 14th World University Futsal Championships. 16 men's teams and 8 women's from around the world, with Malaga University in charge of the organization. It's our 4th World Championships here. It's the university's strategy, in fact, to launch the reputation of the university through sport. We're always working to increase our international academic excellence in different research studies, and for us, sport is an excellent skill. For some students, it's the only opportunity to travel around the world. Relationships built during the competitions can last forever. The atmosphere here is really great. The local people, as well as the organizers, are so helpful. In our country, we're really anonymous, non-professional players. But here, well, we feel like we're playing in the Mondial, and it really feels great. Among the women's teams, Brazil are outstanding. And in an outstanding team, they have one of the world's outstanding players. Representing my country, you know, it's always a big honor. It's a huge responsibility for me because a lot of girls are still back in Brazil. They wanted to come here and represent their country too. So for this reason, I'm very happy to wear the Brazil shirt and to try to defend our title in this World Championship. All the universities naturally want their best players for the tournament. It means they have to be flexible about the students' academic studies.
When I come this time, now in my university heavy exams, and now I'm here. When I'm back in Georgia, I must pass these exams.
Something of a shock for the Spanish fans, the defeat of their men in the quarterfinals, but their misery spelled joy for Belarusia. The university is doing a lot to help the athletes. Athletes get scholarships from the university and are allowed to have alternative examination dates, and that really does support them. This was the end of the road for the Portuguese women, eliminated in the quarterfinal by those Brazilians. Here's one of the losers, far from disheartened though, buoyed up by the support she gets. I'm at the University of Minho, and they make a lot of effort to maintain a high standard of the students through sports and studies. They're doing some excellent work. There's a real balance to integrate the students in both these spheres. It really is a symbiosis. In the men's competition, the Iranians would make the semi-finals, helped by goals like this. Assad University has helped me to go to the championships, not only in Iran, but to come here to the World Championships too. And that's the way they helped me. Iran will face Belarusia in the match for the bronze medal. Sadly, the Belarusians just a little bit too strong. They would get the bronze. In the women's semi-finals, Brazil went through, while Spain, the home nation, met Russia, finally prevailing, setting up a final against the defending champions. I know I can't earn a living from football, but I can do if I become a doctor later. I want to progress in my medical studies now. I want to be a surgeon, and that demands a lot of time to study. So futsal has become a hobby. I don't want to stop football because it's my life too, but at this moment, it's only my hobby. The atmosphere in the Spanish team, very relaxed before the final. They are at home, and they're confident.
One, two, one, two.
Meanwhile, the Brazilian coaches have their final briefing. Brazil have been University World Champions three times in a row, and they don't want to let that trophy go. To be far from your country can make you sad, you know, because we're not at home most of the time. Today, futsal is my life. I can live from it, and I can help my family thanks to futsal. They understand, so they can accept the separation and the distance better. But without their tenderness and attention, we miss our mothers and fathers. So, by force of circumstance, really, futsal becomes our family. So in the final, despite the Spanish confidence, the Brazilian team would duly win the score 3-1 to become University World Champions for the fourth time running. Spain got the silver, Russia the bronze, and the celebrations went on with Vanessa Pereira on the winning side once more. The Russian men relax at their hotel before their final against Brazil, who are favorites for the gold, just like the women were. The Brazilians also tried to keep their nerves at bay, distracting themselves with their telephones before the intensity of the final to come.
Força Brasil!
The Fernando Arguelles sports venue full of passionate spectators, and the first half, Brazil on top. They build a lead of 3-0. Second half, though, different story. They started to make mistakes, and the Russians took full advantage. It really was a tale of two halves. The final score was 8-5 in the Russians' favor. The World University Futsal Championships in Spain.
Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders. When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student-athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.